kingdom, that's who we are. Kids of the kingdom, that's who we are. We love Jesus. We love the Lord. We love Jesus. We love the Lord. We love the Lord. Hi, kids. Welcome back to Kids of the Kingdom. It's good to be with you today. Our first song is going to be one that we've already sung before. What is it, Miss Michelle?
One Big Hallelujah.
One Big Hallelujah. Remember, this is the one that we get to point to our feet, from the bottom of my feet to the top of my head. Let my life be one big hallelujah. All right, here we go. Wonderful. That is a beautiful song. Beautiful song. All right. Now the next song is God is So Good, and it's on page 6, which is a red page. All right. God is so good. God is so good. God is so good. He's so good to me. Second verse, he answers prayer. And then I love him so. All right. Here we go. Mr. Charlie, how are you today?
I'm doing well today. How are you?
Good. What have you brought for us to learn about today?
This is an oboe.
Well, I would have said it looks like the clarinet that you had, only maybe a little thinner.
It is. It is much thinner than the clarinet. It has a different kind of a bore, which is the hollow part inside of it. It also has different keys, and it makes it sound in a completely different way.
Well, how do you make sound on this?
This is a member of the woodwind family, but it's also a member of the double reed family. This is the thing we call the reed, and it's two pieces of wood tied together with string.
I remember you used something like this for the bassoon.
It's exactly the same, but this is much smaller.
Okay.
And the reeds are made in much the same way. You take the pieces of wood, you tie them together, and then you scrape on them with a knife, and then they come out and make a sound like this.
That's that silly sound again.
It is. And it doesn't sound very good when it's played by itself.
No.
But if I hook it on to the...
You have a strap for this instrument, too.
Yes, it helps me hold it so I can
have
my hands free.
It's like magic.
That's right. So when I play into that same reed...
That's such an interesting sound. It's a little like the bassoon, only higher.
It is. It's much higher than the bassoon, and it plays high. Let me show you what the low notes sound like. But it plays high like the flute.
Wow, that is really beautiful. I like the sound. It's different. It's different than the flute that we had the other week.
It is very different.
Yeah.
And the people who write songs for the oboe ask for it to play different ways. Sometimes the oboe is asked to play very soulfully. And to do that, we get into the low notes, the low register. We also do it by the way we take breaths. So we group the notes sometimes when we play music by how the words would be if we sung them. Sometimes we do it just to make the groups of notes sound right. So what I'd like to do is I'd like to play Amazing Grace and show you how the notes are grouped. What I'd like you to do is to count how many times I stop and take a breath.
Okay, kids, let's do this. Okay, every time he takes a breath, we'll put another finger up. Okay, here we go. Well, you took three and then one big one at the end when you finished.
Right.
Did you come up with that many?
And you can tell when I breathe because I have to stop the sound and you can see that I'm opening my mouth to let the air in. Now, sometimes the oboe is asked to do very difficult things. They make the oboe part so that you can't take breaths as often as you need to.
Oh, that must be very hard.
It is. So you have to learn to hold your breath and still play it. Now, fortunately, the oboe doesn't require a lot of air to do that.
Okay.
And I'd like to pretend that Amazing Grace is one of those pieces where I have to do that. We wouldn't normally play it this way, but to show you how we can group the notes together differently than what I just did, let me show you what it sounds like again.
Sounds like a challenge. Let's see if he can do it without breathing. He did it. Oh my goodness, that was very impressive. I didn't see him take a breath, did you, kids? Not just a big one at the end. Oh, wow.
That is a part of learning to play the oboe, is to learning to hold your breath and be able to control it so that you can play very long groups of notes just like that. But you can hear in the upper register, the oboe lends itself very well to the kinds of melodies we can play in worship.
Oh, I love when Mr. Charlie plays the oboe in worship. It's so beautiful. And he plays a lot of duets with his wife, Miss Judy. Remember the flute last week? They play a lot of flute and oboe duets. And so we always appreciate when he plays. Thank you, Mr. Charlie, for bringing the oboe to our Kids of the Kingdom today.
I'm glad I could get to do it.
Wow, Miss Michelle, Mr. Charlie can sure hold his breath a long time.
Oh my goodness, yes.
Do you think that makes him a good swimmer?
I bet he can swim really far underwater.
I bet too. I don't think he could play his oboe under the water though.
Oh no.
That wouldn't be good. Oh well. Now let's go on to our next song, Awesome God. We sang this before too, so this is a familiar one. It's on page 2, which is right at the beginning. It's a white page, page 2. Okay, what instrument?
Let's do the maracas.
I think the maracas would be perfect with this song. All right, here we go. Get your maracas out, everybody.
Our God is an awesome God. He reigns.
Excellent. Well, it's time to say goodbye again, kids. Sing our last song, The Family. So get out your tambourines. Here we go.